really nice scenery up here, isn't it?
It is beautiful. But it brings to mind here, as we look at this, we have a lot of slanting of these layers. What's going on?
So you can see the red rocks and the lighter tan colored rocks back there. You can see they're sitting in an angle. So these layers used to be flat lying. They're deposited in a marine setting. And these are the same rock layers that you would have seen down at the Vermilion Cliffs at the eastern end of Grand Canyon in Arizona. So here we are all the way up in northern Utah, and we're still seeing the same layers. But these layers would have had to be flat over this whole area, all the way down to Arizona and all the way up, extending into Wyoming. And then if you want to think about it as a bubble kind of rising up here, that's when those layers became slanted.
So we have the layers here on our right. Do those layers then continue and go underneath
the
red layer?
Those go right underneath the red layers that we see out here. So there's a whole thick package of rocks that have been kind of churned up on edge right in here.
So that means all that we see on the left used to be here on the right. Is that right?
Yeah, so these layers, like this red layer, the Moen Kopi, used to extend up and over.
Mm-hmm.
So there's a lot that's been eroded away in here. And as the Uinta Mountains pushed up, these layers would have extended over top of the Uinta Mountains. And so what we see is just the remnant that's left. And so as we look off to the north, we're looking out toward the Green River Basin. And so as these mountains rose up, it kind of made a high spot that water couldn't run through initially. And we had a big lake that formed out there. And all of this is happening approximately the beginning of the Cenozoic period around the Earth.
Now, wait a second. You mentioned the Cenozoic. What is that? Where does it fit into all
this? Well, geologists look at the history of the Earth in about four different times, if you will. And it doesn't matter if you're a creationist or a old Earth geologist. We all recognize about the same four periods of time. We think they had different lengths of time. The two views differ from each other, but the one that's deepest is the Precambrian, and we'll actually see those in the core of the Uinta Mountains. And then on top of the Precambrian, we have the Paleozoic. Here's some of the Paleozoic rocks, and we think these would have formed earliest in the flood. And then over here, beginning with these red rocks, that's the beginning of the Mesozoic. It means middle life. So we have Paleozoic, old life, Mesozoic, middle life, and then the most recent period is the Cenozoic, which means new life. And as creation geologists, I think these Paleozoic and Mesozoic rocks would have formed during the flood year, so we have about a year's worth of time to form all that rock, and much of that we can see right in here. But then after the flood, as this erosion is happening, where is the sediment going? These mountains get lifted up, and then the eroded sediment is going into the big lakes that are forming out there. We often talk about a lot of these sedimentary layers being made during the flood. I think there's a lot of sedimentary layers that are going to be made after the flood as well. So we can piece together a whole series of events. So we know that these Paleozoic layers had to be made first, then the Mesozoic layers had to be made, the uplift happens, and then after the uplift, we get those lake sediments out there being laid down.
Are those lake sediments then laid down fairly close to the end of the flood, or?
I think they're laid down after the flood was over. So there's a lot of good reasons why we picture the Cenozoic as the end of the flood. And we see all these mountains rising up in the earliest part of the Cenozoic. And so if you have mountains rising back up and not getting eroded down by floodwaters, that's a hint geologically that the flood's over.
But John, if all of those forces are lifting up the mountains at a time where all of those layers are still soft, then we wouldn't expect to see them crumble and break. Would we see them fold? Is that what we saw in the canyon?
That's right. So we're going to drive just a little ways from here into the core of the Uinta Mountains, and we'll see one of the limestones that's bent and deformed as this uplift took place. And that tells us that these rocks were moving around while the stuff was still soft, just shortly after it was laid down.